Hello, I'm Nikita Pitlia, Data and AI Solution Architect in Microsoft's Health and Life Sciences team. In previous video, we saw how to configure a health bot instance and then use one of the COVID-19 assessment templates. In this video, we'll walk through steps to bring that health bot instance onto a public facing web page. So once you have a workflow finalized and an appropriate scenario completed, the next step is to click on Integration and Secrets. And here, there are two secrets, web chat secret and app secret, that you'd have to copy and have it handy in a notepad. Then go to this link, github.com Microsoft HealthBot container sample, and click on Deploy to Azure. So then this would take you to an ARM template where you can provide the subscription resource group if you want to create a new one or use an existing one from your subscription, and the SKU site location, and then paste the app secret and web chat secret that we copied in the previous step. Then click on next and deploy. So based on the resource group that you have created or chosen here, then you would have to log in to the Azure portal using your Azure login credentials and go to that particular resource group. Here there would be two services created. First, there is an app service which is Linux based, and then an appropriate app service plan. So click on the app service, and here, this is the URL for the app that is hosting the health bot service. So grab this and copy it, have it handy. The next thing that we'd have to do is, if you want to make any modifications, one modification is that when you click on this URL, if you want to trigger a scenario right away without any user commands, then there is a change required in the index.js file. So there are two methods. The first method is by scrolling down here to development tools, click on advanced tools. And when you click on go, this takes you to the app service environment. And here in SSH, then you can use vi commands to make changes to the index.js file. The second method is by using Visual Studio Code. So before moving to the Visual Studio Code base, the first thing is that you'll have to install an Azure App Service Management extension. Once that is done, then here in the Visual Studio Code, connect to your Azure account and then scroll down and look for the appropriate app service, which was the HealthBot v4 Linux in my case, and navigate to index.js in the public folder. So here in index.js file, scroll down to line number 64 and to the function called init bot conversation. Here, if you see line 1110, this would be commented out from here to line 118. So uncomment this and provide a scenario ID of the scenario that you want to import right away on when the user clicks on the bot. So provide the scenario name and then you're ready to go. There are other customizations that are possible. For example, if you want to style, for example, a different bot avatar, or if you want to provide an user avatar image, or if you want to change the background color or hide the send box, all those are possible right from this const style options section. So once you make all these changes, then run this and we'd see this URL. So this is the URL that we have handy. And when I click on this, I get this interface. Now the next step is to take this URL and embed it into our public facing web page. So for example, I have created this very sample website called the Contoso Care. And here on the button click, I want to bring up the health bot instance for COVID-19 assessment scenario. So how that can be achieved is the code base that supports the website that has to be modified. And my code base here is in a Visual Studio. So this is the relevant HTML page where on a button click of COVID-19, I want to invoke my HealthBot v4 Linux Azure website. So on the button click, all I need to do is have this as an iframe tag. And the data source would be the relevant Azure website. Once you make this change, then you can see that on the button click, the HealthBot instance is loading up. So you can make changes. The front-end developers in your team, in your organization, can then play around with this and make required customizations, either have it as a separate, a static image here, or provide a pop-up style chatbot. That depends on the UI, the branding, and the requirements of particular enterprises or teams. A step-by-step guide to configuring the HealthBot, then bringing it onto a web page, is provided as a link in the additional sources of this blog. Thank you for watching, and stay tuned for more videos in the HealthCare Bot video series. Thank you.